Hello and welcome to the Sparger Yarn Crafts channel. My name is Will Sparger. I am your host and I want to thank you for joining me for episode 53, part 2. Today is my finished objects. If you are new, you can check out all of the links in the video description box below. That includes my Ravelry, my Instagram, my Facebook, my shop link, Amazon affiliate links for the tools and things that I enjoy to use, as well as for my filming equipment if that is of any interest to you at all. And then also, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe and hit that bell for notifications so you can always know when I upload a new video. And today I have one finished object to show you, and that is a scrap blanket that I've been working on for a while. And here we go. Just a big, gorgeous, worsted weight, double crochet scrap blanket that is now done. There's some interesting texture over here in the corners, and there's just lots of colors and a lot of fun in here. And this will actually be one of the, because I kind of came up with this idea on my own. I'm sure somebody's done something like it before, but it's pretty simple and I didn't feel like it's worth like writing down a whole pattern when there's just a few simple steps. So I am going to be doing some crochet tutorials for blankets coming up soon, and this is the first one that I'm going to show. This pattern, or this formula that I used for this blanket, works for all hook sizes and all yarn sizes. It's a great way to use up, excuse me, your leftover scraps. Just a great way to get rid of those things that have just been sitting there for a while. I've actually been using this on some really old acrylic that I've had for, some really old acrylic that I've had for a little while, and I just wanted to use it up, and this was a great way to do it. So there will be a tutorial coming for this blanket. I don't have a name for it, and let's see, I did, so this is worsted weight, all acrylic. It's worked up in a spiral, and I'll be showing that how that works in the tutorial. There's some yarns in here that are nice and soft, and then some like the older ones that are, you know, 25, 30, 40 years old. They're a little bit rougher, but this has been through the wash, so it is softer than it was when I was creating it. This is probably, I'd say this is like lapkin. Like this is a throw. This isn't something you would put on your bed. This is something you'd have on the sofa when you're just a little bit cold and you wanna, you know, put something across your legs. All of my ends popped through to the right side of the work after the wash. Oh well, I'll just poke those back down in there. I used a 6mm hook for this to give it a little extra looseness and drape. And the border is half double crochet in this green color. And I like doing that because it gives me these really nice corners. I really love the pointed corners that a half double crochet border gives me with chain two. The only thing about this, because it's worked up in a spiral, is the end of the border is a little weird. The way you have to create the border, so you'll notice here, like there's a little bit more yarn here than there is here, and that's because this was the first corner of the spiral. And so the way that this worked to get the point in the corner is a little odd, but I think it worked really well, and so I will be showing that, of course, in the tutorial. And there's a, I still have a stitch marker in here marking that corner, actually. Well, that went through the wash. So there's a few cool things I like to do. Of course, if you know anything about crochet and you work up in a spiral, your stitches are going to slowly migrate in a spiral. So there's a few things that I did to try and kind of mitigate that and remove a severe spiral from the blanket, because eventually, if you don't do something, it won't be square. It'll look weird. And you can kind of see here in the middle where it wanted to twist. But what I did in the corners is it prevents that a little bit. And I will also, when we start the very beginning of the tutorial, I'll show the fingering weight version I'm working on and some of the things I'm doing on that one. The nice thing about this being simple is that you can change things up a little bit however you see fit to just kind of make it to make it yours and make it unique. And so I'm going to show you what I did on my fingering weight one, or what I'm doing on my fingering weight one, when we start the tutorial. So that is my finished object for this week. I know it wasn't a lot, and this is a kind of short video, but I want to thank you for sticking around for the shortness of this video. Tomorrow is a very short shop update, so I hope you will check that out. And then on Thursday, we're going to have a knit crate video. And on Friday, I haven't decided. I might do life updates if I have enough to talk about for Friday. So you can expect a full week of videos this week, and yeah, thank you guys so much for joining me. I really hope you like this format. Leave me a comment if there's anything you think that you know, does this work, does it not work, do I need to change things up, you know, kind of ideas. I think I'm the only person who's kind of doing it this way. So let me know, you know, this can grow and change as we need it to. So let me know what you think in the comment section below. And I'm going to work on trying to reply to as many of those comments as I can. And yeah, so thank you so much for joining me. I will see you again here very soon on the Spark of Yarncrafts channel. Thanks.